In this chapter, you will discover how library parts can be reserved, edited, and created in the teamwork environment. Project-specific library parts are best saved in the embedded library of the project because they should not be reused in other projects. However, the size of an embedded library should be kept to a minimum. In cases of many custom objects, it's advisable to store them in a BIM server library. Any user with the right to create a library part may create a new object and save it to the embedded library. The rest of the project team need only receive the changes to be able to start using the new object. In cases of company-specific custom objects, which should be reused in any ongoing and new projects, the best place to store them is within a BIM server library. In the following chapter, you will see how many library parts within an embedded library can be modified, as well as how new library parts can be created and uploaded to a BIM server library. Project-specific library parts, like a custom stair object, are best saved in the embedded library of the project itself. This way, they will always be available in the project. All users, regardless of their location, can see and access these library parts without running into difficulties, regardless of which libraries are loaded to the project. Since they are custom-made to fit specific project parameters, they will generally not be needed for other projects. In the following example, Architect 2 would like to apply a different handrail style to the staircases. Let's find out how it can be done in Teamwork. Switch to the ArchiCAD workspace of Architect 2. Activate the Chapter 6.01 section view in the Teamwork Training folder in the view map of the Navigator. The staircase is made up of four identical stair objects, each placed on the relevant story. Select one of the stair objects in the section view. Reserve the selected stair object using the relevant option of the context menu. Open the stair selection settings dialog from the info box. As you can see, this stair object is part of the embedded library of the project and called ToFlightStair. To edit it in its entirety, you can open StairMaker, the library part editor for stair objects, by clicking on the Edit Stair button. A warning message comes up asking you whether you would like to edit all the placed stair objects in the project or only the selected one. We would like to carry out the changes in all of the stair objects of our project, so click All to open StairMaker. Before you can edit the stair, you must reserve the stair library part. So click Reserve in the Teamwork Status panel of the dialog. After reserving the object, you can see how its Teamwork status has changed to editable. Before continuing with the stair modification, let's switch to the ArchiCAD workspace of the lead architect to see how the reservation of the stair library part is visible to another user. Open the same view, the Chapter 6.01 section view in the Teamwork Training folder in the view map of the Navigator. Open the Library Manager window from the File, Libraries and Objects menu. Click on the ToFlightStair.gsm entry to select it in the Embedded Library folder. Notice that the Teamwork status control light is red and says Reserved by Architect 2. Click Cancel to close this dialog. Hover the mouse over the same stair object in the section view and notice that the info tag displays Reserved by Architect 2. Alternatively, you can also select the same stair and open its settings dialog. Click on the Edit Stair button to open StairMaker to try to edit it further. Click All when the warning comes up. Please notice at the bottom of the StairMaker dialog that its Teamwork status displays Reserved by Architect 2. The control light is red, and the OK button is inactive. Click Cancel twice to close StairMaker, as well as the Stair Selection Settings dialog. Deselect the stair in the section view. Switch back to the ArchiCAD workspace of Architect 2. Display the Railing Settings tab page of StairMaker. click to select each handrail symbol on the plan preview of the stair on the right. The selected handrail will be highlighted in red. Choose the wired railing option for all three handrails individually from the railing settings panel on the left side. Click OK to close StairMaker, and OK again to close the stair selection settings dialog. Notice that all the handrails of all stair objects were changed in the section instantly. You may zoom in to have a closer look at the stairs. Company-specific library parts are best stored in a separate Office Library folder on the BIM server, so that they can be easily updated and shared among all users within the office. Let's investigate how a new library part can be created and added to a BIM server library. In our case, to the Teamwork Training Library added to our project in the previous chapter. In the following example, Architect 2 will create a human figure object out of a morph element, which can then be used on 3D visualizations. Open the Chapter 6.02 view from the Teamwork Training folder of the view set in the Navigator. Please notice the famous La Linea animation figure created out of polylines standing on the stair landing. Zoom into the figure to have a closer look at it. Let's create a 3D planar figure out of these lines by using the Morph tool. Display the Favorites palette from the window, Palettes menu. Double-click to set the La Linea favorite for the Morph tool defaults. Select the Straight Rectangular Geometry method from the info box. Hold down the space bar to activate the magic wand, and notice how the cursor changes its shape. Move the magic wand cursor over the contour of the polyline of the La Linea figure, and click it. Now a planar morph element has been created on the section plane tracing the contour of the figure. Let's see it in the 3D window. Activate the Chapter 6.3 view from the view map of the Navigator. Zoom in to the newly created 3D figure. Select the morph element in the 3D window. Let's save the morph element as a parametric library part. Activate the file, Libraries and Objects, Save Selection As, Object command. Click OK to continue when the presented dialog comes up. Enter Linea for the name of the new object in the Save Object dialog. Select the file in a selected folder radio button to save the object to the Teamwork Training Library folder. Click Browse to locate the Teamwork Training Library folder. Click Save to save the object within the Teamwork Training Library folder. The following settings dialog comes up, in which you can name the used materials and pens of the objects. These parameters will be editable in the Object Settings dialog later when using the object in the project file. Click OK to continue. Now the Linea object has been created and saved into the desired library folder. The next step is to upload it to the BIM server. Only the lead architect, as project administrator, has the access right to manage BIM server libraries. You do not need to change the ArchiCAD instance to the lead architect. You can also access the Manage BIM Servers Libraries function from any remote ArchiCAD. However, you need to identify yourself with the username and password as lead architect on the remote machine. Open the Manage BIM Server Libraries dialog from the File, Libraries and Objects menu. Select Lead Architect from the user list. You've already identified yourself as lead architect on this machine, so it's not necessary to provide your credentials again. Select the Teamwork Training Library, then click Refresh. ArchiCAD informs you of the changes made during the refresh process. Click OK to close this dialog. Close the Manage BIM Server Libraries dialog as well. The following window comes up, informing you that the content of the BIM server libraries has changed, so they need to be reloaded. Click Reload to proceed. Now you can place the freshly created linear figure anywhere in the project. Let's place it in the same 3D view, but at another level. Navigate in the 3D view to another stair landing level. Open the object default settings by double-clicking the object tool in the toolbox. Find the new linear object within the Teamwork Training library. Enter linear into the search field. All objects that have linear in their names will be listed. Select the linear object from the search results. Enter the value 1 into the Dimension 2 field on the Preview and Positioning panel of the Object Default Settings dialog. Select Drawing and Figure for Layer. Click OK to close this dialog. Place the object on the top of another stair landing in the 3D view. Just click on the landing, and ArchiCAD will automatically detect the top surface of the landing slab and place the object on it. Send and receive the changes. Save the project. In this chapter, you have seen that there is no need to go through a complicated reservation process, such as exclusive signing in, to reserve library parts. Users can just as easily reserve custom-made objects as they can any other model elements. Users get instant feedback on the reservation status of library parts, so they can always see who is currently editing a specific library part. Project-specific library parts can be easily saved into the embedded library of the project itself, avoiding uploading library parts to the shared libraries. Only project or server administrators have access to refresh the content of a BIM server library. Therefore, unauthorized access and update of the BIM libraries is avoided, and all users will access the libraries with the right content. Company-specific library parts can best be saved in BIM server libraries, providing access to them for all the employees, not just members of the project team.